I'm talking to Dr. Richard Shaffer, oncologist who treats Dupuytrens and Leatherhose with radiotherapy. Richard, can you tell me how well does radiotherapy actually work for Dupuytrens disease?
Thanks, Anna. The way that we test out these treatments, we normally do them in trials. So, I mean, the worst sort of trial would just be to treat one person and say it worked or didn't work. And then the second worst sort of trial would be just to treat a few people. The ideal trial would be what's called a randomized control trial. And what you would do is, let's say, take 1,000 people, 500 of them you randomly assign to getting no treatment, 500 of them you randomly assign to getting treatment, and then you would assume that those groups are balanced because they've been randomly assigned. And you would know that the only real difference is whether they had radiotherapy or not. And then you would see whether there's a significant difference between the no treatment group and the radiotherapy group. Now, we don't as yet have that evidence, although there is a trial in process, but we do have pretty good evidence looking at this, the radiotherapy for Dupuytrens. So this evidence mainly is from a German group, the Professor Siegenschmidt, and he did a trial. Rather than the randomized control trial, he did do a randomized trial between two different dose levels. So what he was trying to do is find out if you give different doses, does it give you a different chance of it being effective? And so he treated people who had signs of Dupuytren's disease, in other words, they had nodules or cords or whatever, so another confirmed Dupuytren's disease, where they either had no contracture, so either their fingers are entirely straight, or a very mild contracture of up to around 10 degrees. Importantly, also, they had to have had progression. In other words, had to have got worse over time, over the last 6 to 12 months. He compared these two different doses and he offered radiotherapy to everyone, but some patients decided that they didn't want radiotherapy, they just wanted to watch and wait. And that was the control group. Control group means that those are the patients who didn't have treatment. But of course, as I say, that was not a randomized control group. So of course, that is a little bit of a flaw in the study, but still, this is what he did. Now, the two doses, they were similar-ish, although, you know, one dose was a little bit better than the other. That's not really our concern at this point. What I would like to tell you about is the difference in outcome between the radiotherapy group and the control group that didn't have radiotherapy. So if we take the 8.5 years follow-up point, in other words, if you watch these patients for 8.5 years and see what happens to them, in the control group, 62% of those had actually progressed, in other words, got worse. Getting worse means more nodules, bigger nodules, more cords, extended cords, contracture, everything. Now, in terms of progression, in the radiotherapy group, only 20% of got worse. So in other words, radiotherapy reduced from 62% to 20% the risk of getting worse by 8.5 years. In terms of those who actually had surgery for significant contracture, radiotherapy reduced the chance of that from 30% with no radiotherapy to 8% with radiotherapy. Now, these are all patients. There were 489 patients, at least 5 years of follow-up. 83 of them actually watched and waited. 406 of them actually had radiotherapy. Half of them actually had radiotherapy with both hands, so actually they treated 718 patients. So that was the outcome. Of course, when we think about it, we can think about those results in three ways, so three messages there. The one I've told you already is, you know, radiotherapy reduces by slightly more than three times the risk of getting worse or needing surgery for a contracture. There's two other messages there. One is 38% of people did not progress. In other words, you know, for some people, radiotherapy just isn't needed, even if they have all those eligibility criteria. But we just don't know which ones they are at the moment. So that's a tricky one. And the last message is, despite radiotherapy doesn't give you 100% guarantee. So 20% of people still had progression by 8.5 years, and 8% of people still needed surgery by 8.5 years. So as I say, there are some people that do fail radiotherapy. Again, we don't know at this point who, you know, why some people do it, some people don't. But those are important messages to take on. So in summary, radiotherapy is effective for Dupuytren's disease. It reduces the chance by about 3.5 times of progression and forming a contracture, which would mean surgery.
Thank you.